Do you periodically check your batteries? I sent you the link. Aren't you addressing the audience?
Guys! I want you to know how happy he is.
Sweet time. Do you believe?
Two.
Yes, Wrong. It's one to win, Lester Lacey. you summarize the case of State of Indiana v. Hearn from your reading?
Oh, I wanted to answer the puppy question.
But I'm asking you about the assigned reading.
Okay, what's that reading?
You have guts, Ms.
Kensington.
Let us say you teach a class at Harvard Law School, a position that you're justly proud about. But a girl on whom you call hasn't read the case at all. Should you let it go, or?
No, I'd throw her out.
All right, then. You heard your classmate. You have just been killed. She cut your throat, so grab your coat. Yes, God, God, but now they're still yours.
Make me a brunette.
What? Brunette? Honey, you're a genetic latte wit. All right, something else is going on here. Back up. Paulette is listening. Spill.
Okay, so I'm Elle Woods, and I came all the way out here for Harvard Law.
That's a good school.
I know, right? But I did it to follow my one true love, Warner. And now he's
dating an evil preppy. So what's she got that you don't got?
She's serious. With mousy brown hair, apparently that's what Warner wants, so you have to make me a brunette.
Whoa, whoa, whoa! Do you know the number one reason behind all bad hair decisions?
Love.
I can help you. I have been there before.
See, my mom was 3/4 Italian, and my father I never knew. But my grandfather came from Ireland. The land where dreams come true.
Ireland?
Ireland. He said all Irishmen are like heroes. They're descended from poets and kings. So I swore I'd get married in Ireland, in a wedding like Lord of the Rings. And my red-headed groom I can see of. As we stroll past the churches and farms, he's a sailor named Brendan or Ian. He can dance without me. drums in a local band, and he told me that he was from Ireland, and I thought he was truly grand. So I let him move into my trailer, and I followed him round in a fog, till he left me for some girl named Kayla, took my savings and told my dog.
Oh. Ivy League school? That's the weirdest reason I...
No Ivy League.
Okay. I grew up in the Roxbury slums with my mom and a series of bums. Guys who showed you all the ways a man can fail. I got through Harvard, I worked like a fool. Worked two jobs in addition to school. So forgive me for not leaping at your tail.
Well, excuse me, just because you got some kind of chip on your shoulder.
You know what? You're right. There's a chip on my shoulder, and it's big as a boulder. With the chance I've been given, I could be driven to excel. I'm so close I can taste it, so I'm not gonna waste it. Yeah, there's a chip on my shoulder. You might want to get one as well.
I'm sorry, but that sounds highly negative.
Hey, I'm just being honest. When you weren't born in the privilege, you gotta work twice as hard.
Wait, two jobs plus law school?
I haven't slept in 6 years.
So I just need to prove to everyone that I'm serious.
What you need is to get to work.
Test and she tasted. She's so close she can taste it.
a strong, independent woman, and you must be reunited with your dog.
Lawyers?
We're not sure if you're aware that the Commonwealth of Massachusetts recognizes your 10-year relationship with Ms. Bonafonte as a common law marriage, which entitles her to equitable division of property.
Huh?
Translation?
We're taking the dog!
Thank you.
you're below the balcony lights are on too. Okay.
She's guilty.
No.
crop at Harvard Law, and we're here to whip up your legal defense. Anywho, we want to free you as soon as possible so you can bring your message back to your friends.
Perfect. That's all I want. This should be easy.
Great. Callahan's briefed me on your meeting, and there is a significant amount of evidence against you. To free you, the jury will need to hear an alibi.
Not gonna tell it.
Even though it could save you?
Yep. Put me on the stand, and I'll be forced to lie.
All right, Miss Limmer, look. If you're not gonna tell us an alibi, then you should accept a plea bargain.
And admit to something I didn't do. But with a plea bargain, you get out within a couple of years. That sounds reasonable, doesn't it? Reasonable to do time for my husband's killer? Not really. I need a legal team who knows I'm innocent. Get out of here, all of you. Guard! It's called a department store.
It's Oh, nothing.
This is my new
Didn't expect the biggest surprise of all to be how impressed I am with you. Stubborn, but all good lawyers are. Proven to be a true leader.
Thank you, Professor Callahan. It means so much. I really appreciate this opportunity to work with you. I've learned a lot.
What you've learned isn't the point. You've got instincts, and instincts, legal or otherwise, can't be taught. Trust your instincts. I thought you were smarter than that.
Is that the only reason you gave me an internship?
It's been nice working with you, Ms. Woods. You can show yourself out.
So listen up, I see no end to what you achieve. Have a
Estelle Woods may represent a defendant in criminal proceedings.
But only if she has a licensed attorney to supervise. And without me, she does not.
Yes, she does. I'm licensed, Your Honor. I gladly supervise.
You work for me, remember?
No, I work for myself. And I don't have to hit on interns, Professor. Did you really think I was just gonna let you get away?
Miss Woods, any day now you may proceed. Call your clergyman.
We call Chutney Windham to the stand.
Oh my god. TTP, total tragic purge.
Miss Windham, what was your relationship with the deceased?
He was my father.
And did you actually see his murder take place?
No. I was in the shower. But when I got out, I saw Brooke standing over my father's body, drenched in his blood.
Miss Windham, on the day your father was killed, did you see anyone suspicious hanging around?
Suspiciously hanging around my shower?
No. Before that?
No. I was out getting a perm.
And then you came home and took a shower?
Yes. I was in the shower.
Now, Miss Windham, you claim on the day of the murder you were out getting a perm. Is this your first perm?
No. I've permed my hair since junior high, about 3 a year.
Interesting. My associate, Miss Enid Hoops, Exhibit A, has just gotten a perm today herself. Now, would Exhibit A's perm be similar to your own?
Duh!
And one more time, you didn't see the murder or hear the gunshot because you were where?
In the shower!
Thank you. Now, Miss Hoops, would you please go dump a bucket of water on your head?
Idiot! You can't get a perm wet for 48 hours!
Exactly. Water deactivates the perm's ammonium thioglycolate and completely ruins it. It's the cardinal rule of perm maintenance. Your perm is still intact and you could have showered that day. Why would you lie about being in the shower? Why would you lie about not hearing the gunshot?
But
why would you?
You think I like being older than my dad's new wife? I didn't mean to hurt my father. I didn't mean to shoot him. I thought it was Brooke coming through the door.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Than this.
And you know in a way I know it all.
woman, a blonde woman. Over the past 3 years, she taught me and showed us all that being true to yourself never goes out of style. Ladies and gentlemen, your valedictorian, Ellen! Law. Vivian's trained for the Peace War. Warren Quinn said he made
Now you know.